This is Chris. He's a brilliant game designer and is defining the gameplay. This is Amelia. She's designing and creating characters for the same video game. This is Robbie. He's producing music and sound effects for a video game. This is Taylor. He's developing a business plan and social media strategy to sell the game. Unfortunately, their project is at a standstill because they are missing an engineer. But wait, here comes Tobiah. Tobiah is a software engineer, and he is furiously writing code and connecting all the pieces together.
A game is art and engineering. When you're playing a game, what it really is a piece of software with art running on top of it. So if the game doesn't react and interact in a realistic way, then it's not fun. And the engineers are what bring all of those components to life. So that is critical for us.
So with the types of innovative projects that we have going on at Cogswell, we require a lot of R&D. Engineering is a key component to support that research and development. With the continued development of the engineering program here, we can rely on added support and more sophisticated support that in turn is really going to help us push that kind of visual innovation that we're striving for with our projects.
Audio sometimes requires engineering as well. We had a situation recently with a game project where an audio asset was needed to be used in such a way that was not supported by the game engine. And so it required some programming, some customization for the audio asset to be used in the way that the project required.
Our audio students understand that it's not enough to have individually produced work on their portfolio. To get a job once they graduate, they also have to show that they can work together as a production team. This is where the idea came from, to develop a project that follows a true industry production pipeline and breaks down the barriers between departments so that Cogswell audio and animation students can work together.
So in the Innovation Lab, I envision we'll take the best artists we have over here and capabilities in the school, and then take engineers, which will grow in-house. And, you know, you can have the best artist, but if he doesn't know how to code, he cannot get it to the mass market. And if you have the greatest engineer and he knows perfectly how to code and do everything very efficiently, but doesn't have something that appeals to people, it's not going to go as well. So this is where things are going to be combined from the artistic side and from the engineering.